production in a factory, a paper mill. Introduction. We use so much of paper in many kinds, that is, books, records, register, program reports, newspapers, etc. Raw materials. Materials required to produce a commodity are called raw materials. Factories require large and continuous supply of raw materials. Paper mills generally use wood from bamboo, eucalyptus and subabul trees. Besides wood, a large number of chemicals such as common salt, caustic soda and so on are used in different stages of paper making. Paper is also recycled in paper mills. Paper mills need electricity for operating its machines. More than half of the electricity requirement is met through the factory-owned power generators. Besides electricity, the mill requires a large quantity of clean water throughout the year. Paper mills and disappearance of bamboos. There are four paper mills in Andhra Pradesh: Sirupur Kagaz Nagar, Rajahmundry Paper Mills, Bhadrachalam and Karnool. Paper mills are generally established near forests where bamboos and softwood trees are available. Due to excessive cutting in the past, there are no bamboos available in the forest. Hence, paper mills are looking for the alternative raw materials like subabul, which are grown in villages. Government is also encouraging people to grow subabul trees on farmland. Process of paper making. Paper is actually made in 5 stages. Each stage has separate section which uses different machines and raw materials. 1. Chipping. In this stage, large wood pieces are cut into small chips with the help of large machines. The chips are separated according to size and the big chips again cut into small chips. 2. Making of wood pulp. The small wood chips are sent to fiber line section. In this section, the wood chips are boiled with some chemicals in large vessels. Through this process, the wood chips are turned into fibers. By using chemicals, the liquid pulp becomes milk white color without any dust. 3. Spreading the pulp. The liquid pulp is spread on thin screen over a cylinder. This is an important stage in the paper manufacturing. The pulp drains out and dries up. Once completed, it is forwarded through the conveyor belt and paper is made according to its width, length and thickness. 4. Pressing, drying and rolling. The drying pulp is presented by rollers to smoothen it. When the pulp dries up completely, we get a sheet of paper. 5. Cutting. The paper is cut in the cutting machine according to the size required. Paper is made into sheets and rolls, then packed and sent to godowns. Production takes place continuously in all sections at the same time. Work in batches. When a lorry load of wood is brought into the factory, the entire wood is given a batch number. The batch system allows a factory to produce continuously throughout the day. It also allows the manager to trace any mistake in the product by checking what went wrong with a particular batch. Working hours and shifts. The paper mills runs all 24 hours in a day. The workers work in 3 shifts of 8 hours each. They are A, B, C shifts. Workers of each shift have to move from A shift to B and then to C every week. There is also general shift for the administrative staff, which is from 9:30 to 5 p.m. Administrative staff looks after the management accounts, trade and sale of the product, workers' welfare activities, etc. working in paper mills. A factory employs a large number of workers of different kinds. Some work in machines, some help them, some take care of electrical fittings, some help in transporting materials, etc. Some of them are highly qualified, like engineers, while others may have educate from ITI and polytechnic colleges. Others may be illiterate, do manual work like sweeping, cleaning, etc. Workers at paper mills. In the section where wood is chipped, there is a lot of wood dust and chips all over the floor. All this has to be cleaned and machines are to be dusted properly. There are permanent workers, while some others may be employed as casual workers. When need arises, some employed as contract workers. The women who work in this factory usually clean the floors and paste labels on the paper packets. Workers who are employed off and on are called casual workers. They come every morning to the factory to see if there is work. Who owns the paper mill? Some people invest large amounts of money and also borrow money from the banks to set up a factory. The workers, managers and administration staff are paid salaries by the owners, share among themselves whatever is left after paying wages and other costs of running the factory. Thus, they get all the profits from the factory. They also bear the loss, if any. Some factories are run by the government for the welfare of the people. Most factories need raw material in such large quantities that natural resources like forests, rivers and mines are rapidly exhausted. They also give out smoke, pollute the rivers and surrounding lands with their chemical effluents. There is a need to control the damage they cause to the environment. The workers who work in these factories often find the work very tedious, and many of them become sick due to the exposure to dust and chemicals. They are forced to live in slums with poor facilities. The major challenges before the government is to find out the ill effects of the factory system and how to make the life of workers comfortable and dignified.
మా వీడియో గనుక మీకు నచ్చినట్లయితే లైక్ చేయండి, షేర్ చేయండి. ఇలాంటి మరిన్ని వీడియోస్ కోసం మా ఛానల్ని సబ్స్క్రైబ్ చేసుకోవడం మాత్రం మర్చిపోకండి. థ్యాంక్ యూ ఫర్ వాచింగ్.